Yo, what's going on, everybody? I had to jump in real quick to a video. I just completed the cycle. Like, literally I hit a home run in the beginning. I mean, I got a triple in the beginning of the game, home run, then a double, and then now I just hit a single right up the middle, and we're trailing in the game, but I'm trying to bring us back.
Finds
But
its way
I
through.
just
Runner from
literally
third
completed the
in the
cycle.
score is
This is
3-3.
awesome.
Safe. And that's what he needed. He has done it. What a performance at the plate.
He's come through for him at the
This is
plate in
amazing.
every way possible in this one. It might be a little bit of a quirk in terms of stats,
I've
but it's
never
still
done
a
this
great
in the
achievement.
show.
Not something a lot of
I
players
think
have been
I,
able to do.
as, matter of fact, I think I did it in
Runners at
like
the corners
2K
here. One
baseball.
away.
I've never
And
done it
next
on
will
the
be the
show.
cleanup hitter, Luke Voit.
I figured there would be more fanfare. This is like nothing. That really sucks, man.
Popped up.
Oh,
That's
shit.
a base hit.
Well, he got me out
Acuña
on that one.
fires it to the plate.
Oh, nope.
Not in time.
He
He
tried to throw
beat it,
home.
and they've got the lead.
His confidence level is so
Oh, and we
high.
took
Really
the
nice
lead.
job of coming through in a big spot. Chasing it outside the zone there.
Yeah, we've
Not
been
all
doing
that
really
close to
good
being
so
a strike,
far.
but he
I
showed
don't know
that he
why the
can
hell he
handle
swung
that
at that.
location. Difficult part of the plate, and just got enough of it to dunk it the
Blue
other
Boy has
way.
been ass
Oh, a
this season.
huge at bat in this
Well,
game coming
we're
up.
doing pretty
Up
good
now
so
for
far.
Washington,
We've got
Luis
a
Garcia,
slew
a
of
contact
division games
guy, good
coming up.
defender.
I just had to do a quick video here on this. This is great.
Two
And I'm
on, one
gonna
out.
add this to the
Swing
video
and a
that I do
miss. Struck him
record.
out. And there's two away.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back
Come
right
on,
there after
y'all.
not
We
getting
can
the
pull
call
this
he
out.
probably should have gotten. Didn't let it
And we're on
affect
like
his
a
focus.
10-game
And
winning
came
streak.
back
Like
with another good
it's been
pitch to
going
get a
really well.
swing.
And the righty deals. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and
Okay,
that is
base is
ball
loaded.
four.
Oh, this is their chance to break it open. If they don't end up winning this ball
Come
game,
on,
they're going
Lane.
to look back at this
Bring
opportunity
us
right
home, man.
here and have some regret.
He's gonna strike out.
Well, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach,
Come on, dog.
he could bust this game wide open.
Oh,
That's the
ah.
third.
Oh, he bobbled,
Boots
he
it
bobbled, he bobbled, he bobbled.
to first, and he beats it.
Yeah, he
Everyone's
beat
safe.
it. Lane's fast too. I think
I
he's
think he
like
got a little
speed is like
passionate on that
94.
play and took it for granted a little bit.
Oh,
So
that boy got
maybe just as
jittery.
much of a mental mistake as a physical one. And with two
Oh, look at
outs,
that. That's
that's a
Austin
tough one to
Riley
swallow
too.
for the entire
I didn't even
defense.
notice those Riley at first.
And now up for Washington, number 45. He blasted one out earlier in the third.
Just a solo
Yeah,
home
that
run,
was when
but
I
an
hit
important
the
swing of the
home
bat
run
in this
after the
game.
triple.
We've already seen him do it once. Can he do it again?
We're 4 for 4 tonight. Let's see if we can do some more damage. Ooh,
Swings through that
swung too
one,
fast that one.
0-1.
Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Ooh,
And he's
got me
down
on that
0-2
slider.
as he swings through it.
Everyone can have a
Dang,
little
that thing
chuckle there.
fell,
He's
man.
had such a
Wow.
great season. Rarely ever do you see that kind of swing.
Checks over to first, back safely.
Come on, man. Go 5 for 5.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
That slider was gonna get me. It was cutting back inside. I swung at the last minute.
And the right-hander deals.
Oh, got him.
Line drive,
5 for 5.
Pitch
Let's
hit.
go.
Yeah, round it, round it. Find the ball.
Throw into third. Safe.
All right.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with two strikes. I think he choked up a little
Oh,
bit,
what a
maybe
great
spread
night.
out, but he got the job done right there.
Yeah, we're killing it right now.
And it'll be Luke Voit to stand in. Number 9
Come
on
on.
third. Number 45
Do something,
at
Voit.
first. One gone. Ripped to third and caught.
Oh, he
Reached
almost
the bag,
got him.
but he's
Damn.
safe. Good job to avoid the double play. So two on with two away. And now it's Luis Garcia.
Garcia been playing a little bit better. He's gonna I don't know, he's gonna strike out.
And that one moves his feet.
Okay.
Corners are occupied with two down.
Come on, Garcia.
Ground ball right side. Over to Swanson.
Oh, I thought I got my foot there. Wow.
Last half of the eight.
All right.
Here's Eddie Rosario.
And so we just got to stop him right here, and we could pull this one out. We were down 3-0 at first, too.
On the ground right side, four. Garcia tossed to second.
Got him. Game over.
Well, another night, another win. This team is a must-watch right now. Even if it goes late, there's a
nice
play, extra innings.
We are doing the damn thing right now, man.
6-3, our final score.
Damn, that manager, man. Is that Snicker? I can't think of his name. Snicker? What the hell is it? Yeah, Cavalli is 4-0. That dude has been pitching his ass off. But, yep, we got a 5-5 game. I had to record that, man. That was just too beautiful to not record. But you will see this added on to the gameplay that I do record. Damn, we got 17 hits in that game. Damn. They are on fire, man. I'm surprised the score went way higher than that. He's leaving too much meat on the bone. Could have slaughtered them. But thank you, guys, for that quick little come and checking out that quick little session. You'll see this added onto another video. Quick edit here. Just wanted to show you that. Okay, quick edit there. I had to take care of the stuff on my team. So I'm going to show you where we're at right now in the standings. 36-8, 13 game winning streak. Been doing really, really well. People kind of coming alive a little bit. See the stats here. See everybody kind of is. Garcia's hitting 288. Vargas and Garcia have just been like the MVPs. Helped me. Luke Voigt still trash. Except he does hit some home runs though. There's my stats. Doing really well. Like damn it. We basically MVP level. 21 home runs. 7 stolen bases. Yeah, I got better at stealing. 436 average. Like, that's an insane OPS. I didn't even know it was that high. We only walked twice because we just, I don't know. They really won't pitch balls. Like, they're coming right down the middle with it. And I'm just like, okay, well, not really down the middle, but they give me something I can hit. We actually got 3 triples. That surprised me. Couple of sack flies. Fielding's good. Really good. So everything is pretty great. Like, our war is ridiculous. That's just insane. But like I said, ever since I used this, let me show you here. Ever since I used this, the dart, it's just been ridiculous. Like, the dart is just really good. Dart and spoke. Because it gets your connect, like, up really high. And tool shed, like, it gets your connect up, but it's more for power. But you end up, like I said, you end up becoming a boom and bust guy, and which is crazy because you're rated higher. Look how, if I use tool shed, my overall goes up to 92. But the problem is, you hit the ball and it's gonna either go over the wall or it's gonna fall. You rarely get hits to the ground. You rarely get those chances at triples, doubles, any of that because it's just boom or bust. And you know, it's crazy to me. We're going to get right back into it here. I'm going to spread. I've been spreading these out. Like, I played like a 10, 15 games in between each video when I record. Let's see here. I think we'll throw. Let's go. Yeah, let's do the 05s. But other than that, I mean, we've been doing pretty good. The thing that's been helping us is the pitching, though. Like, not everybody's not hitting really well. They're hitting home runs, but the pitching has really been the thing that's been holding strong.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the Washington Nationals going up against the Atlanta Braves.
I'm very surprised by
John
that record.
John Chambi alongside Chris Singleton. And Singy, we're going to see a nice...
I don't know how long we're going to hold on to it. We have some weak opponents, though.
These guys are really firing on all cylinders right now. And to me, the important thing is that they're doing the little things well. They're not
very surprised by the Philadelphia ranking. They just made it to the
They're playing good situational baseball, executing
the World Series
key areas, and that's how you string together wins. So we'll see if they continue that in this one. Well, no doubt about
it. Look at his ERA. That's crazy to see from Max Fried.
In order to bring that ERA down. Now, he's got good stuff. He's just got to be able to have confidence, trusted, and really go after
54 RBI so far, first in the NL, probably the lead.
And miss barrels of bats.
He's been doing really well. Since I changed that thing, that's...
That one ripped.
See what I'm saying? That's already out of there. Dang. I mean, he did. He did leave it hanging. I mean, he's like, my bad. Hey, we come in with it, God dog. Couldn't ask for a better start.
Well, I'm not really sure how he kept that fair when you're out in front on a break.
I didn't think it was gonna be a home run. I thought it was gonna be like a double or something. I thought it was gonna hit the side. But
not this time.
Number 45, getting ready to hit. This guy makes great contact, one of the best in the game at putting bat on ball.
He's got such
our power ain't that great either. We only hit about 50-60 in power.
Square to the plate. There's a good chance that his bat stays.
Why is he hanging him? I was gonna swing that one, that was a little high, but this dude is tripping.
Come on, guy, get your pitch up there.
Next offering,
that's a good
is
pitch
in for a strike. Nice warm day.
I guess I thought that was going to be outside the zone.
Does that change anything, Chris, especially for the hitters?
Absolutely. You feel so much more comfortable at the plate. You're not worried about, you know, getting jammed on fastballs inside.
See what I'm saying? He threw three pitches
kind of be more selective
into the zone. He didn't even try to go outside the zone.
Get the barrel to it in that part and get on the inside part of the plate as well.
The batter, number 40. Man, it's second with one away. Now it's going to be three. Number 45.
It's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it.
Oh yeah, runners in scoring position. We're hitting like 500. I was like, damn.
Everyone else is in slow motion, and he's in full speed.
I almost swung at that because he's hanging him right now. I don't know what he's doing.
The lefty, the 1-0. Right side.
Yeah, he got that one. Should be enough for him to run.
Nah. And there's two away. And here's the first baseman, number 45. He had a big swing for these guys way back in the first inning.
Yeah, Boog, he didn't waste any time in this one. The solo shot really got his team going, and he's looking for more right here.
Come on, man.
In there, and it's
I don't know what's up with them hanging these curveballs. All right.
Get ahead on a good hitter as well. He's a little bit more confident to move to the at-bat.
Ooh.
And fouled off.
I told you, man, these dudes will not throw outside the zone. I have no idea, like, what they won't even attempt to try. Okay.
They go
one.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. Is going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even
Damn.
Though he's behind in the count.
That was nasty.
Pops it up.
Man, the bat almost went out there to
Nationals
way past second base.
But they still lead it 6-3.
Well, just
that's another one.
Big win today, and everyone is
team been holding up well though. I got to give it to them.
So
like
well.
I at first
pack in the stands, and it's just an exciting brand.
I was having to do a lot.
We'll see how far it goes,
but
right
hell,
now,
they kind of
no
hold strong.
End anytime soon.
Especially Gore's pitching like really
Chris
well.
Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Shambi saying so long.
All right, next game. Gore's pitching really good. Cavalli's been pitching really good. Strasburg is the one I was surprised by. His stats have dipped. Like his overall has dipped. But he's pitching better than he ever has. Like it's really insane.
It's the Washington Nationals.
And it sucks because in real life I think he's done.
First pitch coming at you right after the break.
This dude is the one that's tripping me out because his overall is the highest out of any pitcher, Josiah Gray. But he cannot keep the ball in the park.
To go and towing the slab in this one.
That's crazy. Spencer Strider is 1-5.
He hasn't exactly been stellar here on his home mound.
Look at his ERA. That's insane. He's probably going
to
win Rookie of the Year, but that's crazy.
In front of the city. And you know this guy no different. He wants to be more effective.
Definitely a video game.
You know, you look at the numbers. They haven't been great at home. I'm sure he wants to turn that around, and we'll see
now
if he's able to start.
This dude right here throws nothing but
45 at the plate with two away. Swings through that one.
bed. Stay hot. Here you go.
Two outs. And ball one.
One and one.
No score, just getting started. Top of the first.
Get in there. Yeah, there we go.
Center field. So a two-out knock keeps the.
That was outside the zone too. I looked like it was in.
Well, his hot hitting continues. He's been getting great results lately. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way.
Yeah, see, I thought that. I thought that got way. I thought that was in there. Like, wow.
Out front, man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee. And now they've got some speed on first. So we'll see if they try to get.
Now he's hitting better.
And here's Luke Voit. This splits between April and May there.
He's still trash. The thing about him is, if he does get the pitch, he does that.
Left center.
But except for it's mostly it could be a home run.
And that'll do it. And now the Braves will get their first crack at it. No score.
All right.
Here is Ozzie Albies' update.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? Look, really they winning 5-0 right now.
Here at home.
Josiah Gray. I don't know what's wrong with him. It makes no sense. How his overall is the highest, but he can't. I don't know. It's like he cannot stop anybody.
He'll do it himself. That's the third out.
They either get hits or they get earned runs or home runs, and he just. I was like, why is he even rated at 80 something? He's like rated like an 87, 86, something like that.
Number 45.
Let me double check that. No, I'm not gonna look at it here. Yeah, so check him. He's rated 86. Look at his stats. 85 on strikeouts. But the home run is a 59 and his hits are 70. I just don't understand what he's doing. Like, those are pretty decent numbers, but the home runs are low, you know, stuff like that. But his pitching clutch is 59. But he just cannot keep it. Like in the park. I'm surprised he got 3 wins. But he got a 6.11 ERA. We get him going. That's it.
Strider picks over. Hassel back in standing.
Because everybody else is like pretty good.
Wait for a good one. Drive it, kid.
Hell, even Corbin doing good.
Another move to first.
He's doing long relief.
Yeah, they're keeping him close. In there for strike one.
I thought dude was gonna try to steal.
And a pitch. Runner on the go.
There he goes. They got him.
Misses.
Nope.
Throw there.
Got the swipe back too late.
Singy, he definitely showed off.
They definitely had his ass though.
Yeah, it turned out to be a bang.
Dude threw the ball to the side, so he had to reach
in the data, and that stolen base wasn't possible without that sprint speed.
I thought at some point he was gonna go.
That one ripped left.
Yeah, we got
field.
That one. Oh, what a catch.
In on the warning track. Runner tagging for third.
Well, off the bat, I thought for sure it had enough to get out of here, but that wind's kind of blowing in from left, and I think that's what made the difference.
Hassel's been pretty good.
Here's Orlando Arcia.
Getting on base, especially. Hope he does that next year.
Can't field it cleanly.
Really, really, dude.
Safe at first as they can't make the play.
Well, at least I can get an error.
One down.
Ooh, 9-0. See what I'm saying, man? That dude just got raked. Like, it's insane. He got raked over the post. It's just insane how bad he is on this game.
And he grounds one to the
being
right
the highest
side.
Rated pitcher.
And he takes it himself for the out.
On the team. It's stupid. Makes no sense.
Base is empty, one away. Number 45 digging in for the Nationals.
I guess they didn't come play today.
First pitch, and he just misses.
Boy, throwing 100. God damn. Sixth inning.
And there's a ball.
He's clearly trying to work him away here, both pitches off the plate. If you really want to put the ball in play, you're going to have to stay back and drive it to the opposite field.
Oh, got me on that changeup.
Everyone can have a little chuckle. Ooh,
that was a nasty pitch. Wow.
Rarely ever do you see that kind of swing.
That one is absolutely belted. That's back there.
Oh, it's off the wall.
Man, he hammered that one to center. I thought it was out of here, but Wynn just absolutely killed it.
Yeah.
Number 45, 12-0. Digging in for the Nationals. It's interesting he plays kind of
nasty.
A power spot defensively, but runs
well,
pretty
well. Like the winning streak is
so
over with.
When you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the
in
position.
In the worst way, too.
When you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole
team that much better. That's right.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Got him.
Pitch has popped up.
Oh, right over his shoulder.
And they're happy to play station to station right here. Bases loaded, nobody out.
Well, he wasn't afraid to hit with two strikes.
I thought it was falling right over the shoulder.
But he got the job done right there.
That's a good hit.
Luke Voit at the plate. Number 14 at third. Number 9.
Double play incoming.
Second. Number 45. On at first with nobody out.
Oh, shit.
In the air.
Did he get
out
it?
Towards left center.
He did not.
And he makes the catch. Runner tagging from third.
Yeah, I got a sack fly.
He's in on the sack fly, and it's 12-1.
Yeah, at least we scored.
Right there, he's
on the shutout.
Looking for more than just a sack fly with the bases loaded and nobody out, but you'll take it. Now it's up to the guys coming up behind him to pick up the rest of those runners on base.
Smash to the left side.
Oh, what
nice
a catch.
Stop. Goes to second for one. Double play.
That's a hell of a double play.
Quinn killing to end the inning. Home
you just got to get it to him.
Number 8 straight ahead. It's the Braves 12.
That's awesome, Riley. That's a great play. I don't cut it off. I'll show it.
Well, this team was ready from the first pitch of the ball game.
Yeah, they really
swinging
were.
The bats,
they kicked our ass. That one.
I feel like they set the tone, and that tone created a momentum that took them all the
look
way
at
to
him.
Finish line.
Three, nice only three today. Innings, six
final,
hits he gave up. Four strikeouts, five ERA. Five
home
runs.
I'm John Ciambi saying,
look how many people hit a home run. Michael Harris, Contreras, Garcia. Like, come on, man. I don't know what be going on with that dude, man, but he plays so garbage. It's crazy how bad he is. I don't understand it. And then look, I'll show you. Let me go to the roster. Look at him. He's the highest rated other than me. If I gain overall, I'll be above him. But he's the highest rated player. Me and him, 86 overall. With the highest rated player on the team. And he has a 6.04 ERA. Like, that, what? You know what I'm saying? It's trash, man. I don't know. I can't even tell you what that dude is doing. All right, but I can show you, so check my starting pitchers. So all of them got fired, like all of them. He's at six. Like look at Strasburg. A 1.25 ERA. He's 7-1. 65 innings. Like only giving up five home runs. Only nine earned runs all season long. He's pitched nine games. And he's only giving up a run per game. That's insane. And his stats are down from 92 to 81. Joe Ross, who has always been trash, like jumped from a 70, I think it was 75 overall to 80 overall. Look at his stuff, man. A 2.35, a 3.4 ERA. Only gave up 16 earned runs so far. He's 6-1. And he's rated 80. Kay Cavalli, 79. 4-0 is what he said. 4-0, bro. 2.05 ERA. These guys are all rated lower than Josiah Gray. Mackenzie Gore, 2.81 ERA. Nobody else is over a 3 ERA but his ass. And he's the highest rated pitcher. It makes literally no sense. Oh, I was wrong about Patrick. I thought he was doing fine, but yeesh. Yeah, Patrick is Patrick. I have no idea what happened to that dude after the after they won a championship. He just fell completely off. Except for Merrill's, all right, doing all right. Not bad, not bad. We still got some prospects and stuff coming. Eric Fetty, I don't know. He just, it's like he fell all the way off. I don't understand how his stats went down that low. Is he hurt? Damn, his stats dip low. He was like a 74. He went down to 70. I don't know. I don't even understand what's going on with him. What's the D for? Is that designated for assignment? I don't know who half these other guys are. But relief pitching is doing well. Some of these other things are doing well. We got some new guys, but that's crazy how his overall has jumped above Kyle Finnegan's. Kyle's been pretty good, though, this year. 21 saves. Sorry about that. Just going through the thing. Like, let's go to the training facility. Arm strength. I really don't need any of this stuff. It's just... No, you know what? You can't never get enough contact. That's fine. I don't really have time to play through the game. Let's go with the City Connects. Robert Hassel was feeling pretty good. Now I guess he hit the cold streak. Okay.
Live from Nationals Park in Washington, D.C., the show brings you game one of a big four-game set. It's the New York Mets and the Washington Nationals. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this.
And now, Strasburg. 2023. I just think it's crazy how good he's pitching now versus the season before when he was rated a 92.
Just about to get underway. On the hill, that's an insane great start. It'll be Steven Strasburg.
Oh, they scored two runs on us already. Oh, spoke too soon.
ERA just over three. He's been pretty great for most of his big league career. Can't wait to watch him in this one.
That one's in there, 0-1.
That's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation, runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
True.
Check on the runner, and he dives back in safely.
Come on. Stay hot, huh? Got him.
And that one hammered.
God damn.
That's back there.
We heard that one.
See you later. His 23rd of the year, and they throw up.
Man, we got all of that. God, dog. You know, you hear that pop off the bat? That perfect, man. Tied it up. We did our job.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for.
Listen to that sound.
And hits it out of the ballpark.
If they're going to play it again. There it is. That pop. Surprised we didn't hit that old 400 yards.
One out, base is empty. Eduardo Escobar now at the plate.
The third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
I wanted to play some right field, but they like.
Line drive. Nice got him. Grab.
Wow, that was an awesome leap.
I didn't think I was going to get it.
Great reactions, great athleticism, and he snatched that thing out.
That's
of
something
air,
nice for the video.
Up now for Washington, number 45. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Ooh, next pitch almost. Is downstairs.
Okay, like he actually nibbling here. Confidence is down a little bit. I should have swung at that one. That's a little inside.
Ooh. Swings and misses. And
nice pitch.
Two and two. Singy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offensive standpoint anymore. So when you see somebody who contacts the ball like this, do you think of that as plus value?
Absolutely. If he's doing damage now, if he's rolling over and grounding out, then it's a different story. But yeah, if he can put the ball in the gaps or over the fence.
Oh, 100%. Good pitch.
And a swing and a miss down on strikes. And there's
good
down.
Pitch.
And now it's the polar bear.
Oh, I should have showed it. Good pitch. God, he got me with that one. I thought he was just going to try to go low with
right
a fastball.
Kicks, deals. That one to first, and that chance handled. And that takes care of Alonso.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
So one out, nobody on. Gary Sanchez at the plate.
Now batting. Catcher.
In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a
doing
guy
a good job.
That hits the ball hard.
All right, Corbin.
Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher the gets to the bag for the out. Tyler. Number 45, digging into the Nationals.
Man, we on the heels, but
I don't
know.
Baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball.
Damn.
And is kind of different from the players that we see.
Oh, he ran right past it.
Bare hand, and it gets by him.
How did you mess that up?
It started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock
oh,
it down.
Oh, come on. That's an error. That is not a hit.
The guys are starting
that dude ran right past
bats.
That ball. I can't believe they gave that a hit.
The pitch. Got him. Two gone
of course,
now.
Luke. Of course.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting the call. He probably should have gotten. Didn't let it affect his focus.
Just absolutely lost. Look at him.
Another good pitch to get him
swinging. You know, he just got nominated. Oh, they want me to steal. For a silver slugger. He's a fine. Shit. Nope.
Pitch in for a strike. But he's back Ooh. In time.
Got back. If he slides stepping, I'm going back.
Pickoff move to first, and he just got his hand in there.
Yeah, I don't know if that's a good idea to try to steal right here.
And the pitch.
Yeah, he slide steps again. You're going to have to hit the ball, bro.
Number 45, off of first with two away.
They still want me to slide.
Here's the pitch. Runner goes again. Got him looking.
Nah, he struck him out. Shit.
Damage control right there.
That's what I told him, man. He want me to steal, but I'm like, he slide stepping.
Number 45. Way to go. For Washington, the first baseman, number 45. And a pitch. Swing and a miss.
Damn slider.
Next pitch is outside.
That's where very close.
Strike two.
He put it in the same spot. Shit, that was a great ass pitch. The same spot.
Right-handed reliever. And it's filled up.
At this point in the game, okay. You cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Got him again.
Belted. That one back.
Heard that pop again. Damn!
Everyday dream.
I thought he got out of here.
Outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls.
Good catch.
The gaps, they practice this. These guys know
that was a good win for them.
Series ahead of them, but they come out, establish, and set the tone in the first game of the series. Very important to get that. Put you in the driver's seat to win game two, and then push yourself to a series.
And they chased Strasburg. He gave
a hit. This one ends with a final score of 6-4 for Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at
losing
MLB
a little bit here.
Thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon. And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the New York Mets and the Washington Nationals. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this.
Washington Nationals.
Just about ready to go, and today's starter, right,
Joey
Ross. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Very dominant his last time out, picked up the win, only allowed one run. These guys would love to see him back on his game in this
one. I should have swung it there. It was too close inside.
In the air to left center.
I was just a little anxious.
Sierra makes the grab. That's out number two.
Should have swung it there, though. Bad one.
Set for the bottom of the third, and now up for Washington, number 45. Scherzer back to work. That one missed.
Going up against Scherzer. Ooh.
Swing and a miss.
Nasty slider.
Out front that time.
That's some nasty stuff.
Kicks, fires. That's towards center.
Yeah, it's going. Oh, it fell. Okay.
Find it. Off to a good start with a
not bad. I thought it was going to go right to him.
Really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit.
Watch this strike out. Watch this.
To dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Gotta love Luke Voit.
Tap softly third base side, a swinging bunt. Off
surprise.
There's one. Over to Alonso.
Yeah, double play. Even worse. Thanks, Luke. Oh, and if you hear if my voice sound different, I don't know if I'm coming down with something or not. My son just caught the flu. So, I don't know. I could be catching it. I don't know. I just woke up this morning and sounded really raspy, and I'm just kind of like, okay.
Slow roller to first.
It's,
and he handles it himself for the out.
But there's like this flu bug going around
the ball out of
the community and schools. Like, I went to the school to check him out.
To hit for the Nats,
and they had 15 kids on the list.
Kind of
checked out before him. I was like,
runs
what?
Pretty
like,
well. So, kind of when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting
like,
someone
damn.
That has maybe above average speed, but he does. And there's something you don't see very much.
Like it was crazy. Like they were checking out like every other minute or so. It was like from since like 10 o'clock, it was like kid checked out 10:05. Another kid checked out 10:07. I was like, damn. And he had like 103 degree temp or something. I was like, what the hell? Oh God, they got him.
I don't know if he was looking to go right there or not, but he was clearly fooled by the pickoff move. Quick feet, quick release over there by the pitcher. Really quick tag as well.
Next one off the plate inside. Now 2-0.
Can't be doing all that, man. Can't get caught on base, man.
Scherzer deals. In the air to left center.
That's gonna fall.
Canna in position. Pulls it down.
Probably
should have
hit that hit contact. Hit that one.
That is the inning. We're through. One down. And now the first baseman. We're holding
strong
45.
At three.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Come on, baby.
See you driving. Let's go.
Huh.
That's a strike.
Yeah, I ain't like it. It's a slider. There we go.
Swing and a line drive.
That was a slider too, huh? I thought it was a fastball.
So a man aboard now with one away.
Another multi-hit game for him. He's been really hot lately. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
All right.
One gone, runner at first.
Come on, boy. Do something, man.
The next to hit. Righty delivers. This one in the air, right field.
God damn it. Okay.
Naquin makes the grab. Two down.
I swear to God, that dude is like, man, he has done nothing like all season. I'm so surprised that he's still hitting cleanup. It makes zero sense.
On the ground to third. They get the force, and that is that.
I can even see if they want immediate cleanup or something.
Ball game, quick game. We were looking for a little bit more. It seemed it.
Man, took the W.
We're going to break out, but a total of four runs combined. Really good pitching and defense on both sides. Just a couple of key swings making all the difference.
We'll take it.
Here in Washington, D.C., glad you're with us. And Chris, of course, you have to think about that 2019 World Series run. Really impressive by the Nats.
Ooh, they gaining ground on us a little bit.
NL East matchup. It's the New York Mets and the Washington.
Hey, we got to
just about set to go.
Gotta get
now.
Some more wins going.
On the
pull ahead.
Now, Cade Cavalli.
I don't want nobody on our heels.
Last time out, six innings, a quality start. Hey, if a guy will give you that, you'll take it every single time.
Oh, man, it caught me so off guard. Right, I mean, I didn't think he was going to go straight down the middle like that. I swung it way too late.
The Nationals gone.
Man, they caught me off guard.
And here's the first baseman, number 45.
Put a good swing on it. Here we go.
First offering misses the mark.
Uh-huh. Come on.
And the righty deals. Oh, now got this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone.
That's what I tried to do that first time, man.
He flexes his power with that swing, his 24th home run of the season, and that gives him a lead. It's 1-0.
All right. Too bad, solo shot.
Fast hands to be able to hit that velocity fastball on the inside part of the plate. In my experience, when you're looking out over the plate,
you got all that one.
The ball to travel, it's
434.
Hit a pitch in that location. That's a tremendous swing.
And now number 45.
Well, shit, they tied it up. Yeah, he got me that first time with it.
First pitch.
I was shocked at how
misses.
Fast he threw it down the middle.
One and oh.
All right, boy, you better not throw one of them fastballs in here no more.
Hey, let's go, big fella.
Ooh, that side. One. Oh, man, that was close. That was close.
Hey, he hangs it, you bang it, kid. Here you go.
He hangs it, you bang it.
At the belt and fires. Pitch misses there.
All right.
And a strike.
Hey, get your pitch, see through.
Come on. Give me another one of them ones in the middle. You want to play around?
Yeah, the right-hander deals.
Oh, now, you want to nibble. Okay. The crowd booing him. Hey, no. Challenge him.
The pitch.
That's a good pitch. I ain't like that one, though.
Now just a cement mixer slider right there. It's a great pitch to hit if you can recognize
what's gonna
it early
do?
And jump on it.
Got him again.
A swing and a drive.
Got him again.
That
go, keep going.
There.
Keep going. Got him again.
Homer number 25 of the year.
Got him again.
Slide in front in the sixth. It's 4-3.
Yes, sir.
He's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one.
Boy, I told him not to come down the middle with another one.
He dropped the barrel right there. Got a fastball down at the knees where he'd prefer it. So many times now, guys are happy
to go low with it.
Elevated fastball.
Scooped it right on up.
His eyes got big when he saw that one coming.
Boom. Oh, man. All right. Looks like we chased him off, too.
First pitch, not close.
Clearly didn't come out of his hand the right way. Left that curveball way up.
Vargas at second with two down.
Come on.
And that one pulled foul.
Oh, I thought that was another one for a minute. I was like, dang.
Count 1-2.
Good pitch.
For a guy that's been swinging the bat well all game
that
long.
Was an ugly
that was
one.
A pretty ugly swing right
yes,
there.
Yes, it was.
I'm sure he'll tighten it up on this next
one. It happens sometimes, though. Get the ugly one. Yeah, you trying to go inside.
Runner leads away at second.
Oh,
and a swing and a
hell
miss.
Of a pitch.
Good job at damage control right there. Eighth inning coming up.
Swung way too early at that.
And the Mets three.
Can't get them all.
Well, this was a
took the W, though.
Using six pitchers in this ballgame to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton. The next guy stepping up and getting it done. You got to give him a lot of credit because this is
all right. I think this is
we'll
the last one in the series.
The next couple of days.
And this one ends with a final score of 6-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shum. Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us.
How many games have we played, dude? I feel like it's been like five or six games.
It's the New York Mets and the Washington Nationals. Ready to go now? Getting the
right.
Nod in this one. Mackenzie Gore. Tell
oh,
us about
God,
him
DeGrom.
That
oh, no.
Race,
this is
really
an L.
Outing for him last time. Scatter two.
Rudder takes off.
He did not get there. Look at that jump. That was horrible jump. The thing about Hassel on here is that he attempts to steal bases so much. But he's like, I don't know if it's the fact that he's not fast enough or something. He's an 85 on speed, but he gets caught a lot stealing. Like, let me see. Like, I thought he had more than that. Yeah, he's 4-4, but man, I remember
right
spring when I was doing spring training. Every time
the
I turned
no
around, he was getting caught stealing.
Jacob DeGrom as a college shortstop, and then a ninth round pick by the Mets was going to turn into this good of a pitcher. Back to back Cy Youngs in both 2018 and 2019.
Yeah, I smell an L coming.
The wind of the pitch. And there's a ball.
This dude is good.
Incredible. You look at that benchmark of 200 innings.
Yes, please walk me.
Over that in 2018 with 217. And the sub 2 ERA just impressive.
Should have swung at it.
1.70 to lead the league.
Oh, I swung at the ugly one. Glad I got something on it. I could have walked right there. He trying to get me. Sorry about that. That was my phone in the background. Come on.
Three balls, two strikes, the count. Gets under it, pops it up.
And pop
McNeil
it up.
Has a beat on it. And puts the squeeze on
that's
that
DeGrom.
One. And that will end the inning. Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate.
Now batting.
Yeah, nobody on this.
Out to short.
When you do simulations,
the throw over to Fox. That's one. And it's a
when you do simulations, it definitely takes those guys who are great pitchers. It takes their stats and stuff into accountability. And it's not most of the time when you go up against guys like Aaron Nola, Kershaw, a big, you know, big name guy, Scherzer, and it's one not gonna it's not gonna really let those guys lose Nationals. Those matches.
And first offering is fouled off.
Yeah, I got April Player of the Month. How about that?
One down, base is empty. Good eye right there. 1-1. And that skips in the dirt.
Yeah, he ahead right now, so that's why he doing all this.
And a pitch.
He's like, nah.
Fought off foul.
Like, yeah, I'm not going to give you nothing. He's going to do another pitch jump now.
Take a deep breath, reset. A couple of change-ups. Probably won't see another one here.
Look out.
Look at that.
And it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, they're going to have to right there with one
of his best pitches. Yeah, right now. Dude's like, yeah, I'm just going to pitch a bunch of junk, and I hit you in the ass, something like that. That's fine. I'm going to keep our 3-0 lead, though.
This one lifted in the air, left field.
God, just go back. Hey, no
trouble here, puts it away for the out.
What you doing?
Just pulled off of it
like
a little
try
bit.
Try to
right
run
there.
Forward. I'm like,
front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
What you going
to
do, Alfred?
And let's go, kid. Here we go.
Nothing.
And a swing and a miss.
Absolutely
and that.
Nothing that you've done all season long. Thank you. Moving on.
Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to him. Guillorme on second. Alonso on at first with two down. To the right side. And that one handled. He steps on the bag. And that is that. So a strong showing there from the Nats bullpen. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit. So first and second with one man gone. And now number 45.
Now I gotta try to be the hero again.
Got some good opposite field power
against DeGrom.
What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield.
Is dude, he's killing me with this circle change.
A very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
Late swing fouled off.
Shit. Now he got me right where he want me.
Here's the 0-2.
I didn't think he was going
to
do that.
Over to McNeil. Double play.
I thought he was going to nibble.
Inning over.
They made it look easy.
You already said they
nice
can't
speed.
Seem to break through. You can't
he's two outs
against
away.
These dudes. These number big name guys.
Digs in now.
He's still pitching. Look at that. It's the ninth inning.
Well, just very efficient out there on the mound.
He's going to get that complete game shutout. Look at his confidence. Super high.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Next offering is
hell, I can't
back.
Do nothing with what he pitching, man. 1-on-1. Jesus.
The pitch. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side.
That's bad. We ran into a bus all with this dude.
Makes the play, and there's two down.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
It's crazy. He just came out there, just got the full shutout against us. And reminded, like, yeah, what's up, young bitch? One hit. He only got one hit the whole game. It's crazy. I knew it was going to be an L. As soon as we saw him, I was like, yep, it's going to be an L.
He just hit his 25th home run of the season, and it's not even June. Let's bring in Sean Casey. Casey, he's tied your career high before the All-Star break.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
What's going on here?
Oh, man, you kidding me? I'm like, I thought 25 home runs was a lot when I hit it back in 99. Now I'm watching this guy. He has 25 before June, so pretty epic pace he's on.
And how impressive is it to see a guy go on a tear like this? And more importantly, how does he maintain this for the rest of the season?
Well, I think when you see a guy hitting at this pace of home runs, I think it really is consistency, just really catching the ball out front, barreling it up. And I think if he continues to do that, we might see some records broken.
All right. That was really cool. They added that in there. All right, man. I'm going to end here. Yeah, when we come back, I think, let me look at the schedule here. Let's see. So we got San Francisco up next, June. Tell you what, I might try to get us to about the All-Star game, about the home derby and their home run derby. Cause I'm pretty sure they're going to put me in it. The home run derby and All-Star game. I think we'll come back and record those and maybe that Houston series right after it. Yeah, but all the rest of these, I can play up to the end. Yeah, that'll work. But thank you guys, as always, for rocking with me. Hope you guys enjoying the series. I was starting to get the hang of this hidden thing on here. It's looking pretty good. Like we might be getting an MVP. But got to try to get the championship as well. And that is a little bit difficult to do when everybody has days where they want to hit and everything like that. But I appreciate you guys, as always. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe, guys, if you need the content. And come back for some more. See you in the next one. Peace.